Hello, I'd like to show you how to write a bottom-up tree automaton that accepts the same tree as those regular tree grammar. And let's first have a look on what trees those regular tree grammar is generating. And the syntax is somewhat similar to a context-free grammar. So we have a set of non-terminals, which in this case just contains the S. And the non-terminals are replaced by other non-terminals or by trees. So we will start with an S node. And then we have those set of rules. And the rules say us that we will replace the S by a tree. So we have those trees given in a bracket format. And we can either replace a tree by those left rules. So the pipe is an OR, and I will now choose the left side inside the brackets. So I can replace the S by a tree that has an A as root node and that has two child nodes B and A. Or I could use the other rule and replace those S by a node, by a tree that has an A as root node. And when I use the right side of those rule, then the child nodes are an A and another S node. And then I can again decide whether I want to replace those S by B and A. So let me just replace it by another subtree with an A as root node and B and A as child nodes. Or I could just go on and use the write rule again. And if I use the write rule again and again and again, then I will, I will get a tree which has a lot of, so those, a tree where there are a lot of child nodes on, where a lot of leaves on the left side, which are A's. And then after a while, I will get to the end of the tree where there are two leaf nodes, B and A. And that are the trees that, so, that my bottom-up tree automaton shall also exist. So, my bottom-up tree automaton consists of four things. So it consists of a set of states and then alphabet, which will be the same as the one in our grammar. Then we will have a finite state and we will have a set of production rules. And I think you can easily figure out those three things on your own. But the most interesting things, which I will show you now, are the production rules. So the production rules will be a set. And, well, as you may know or not know, when we have an empty tree, it's denoted by two brackets. So that means we have, that's an empty tree that consists of no nodes. And below all those leaves, we have those empty trees. So it's basically, maybe you can imagine this as being some kind of empty word, but in a tree context. So it's an empty tree, a tree with nothing inside it. So when we are starting at the bottom, we have empty trees. We can read empty trees. So we will have a production that consumes root nodes, that consumes those leaf nodes, those terminals. For example, could either, this one could read an A, and it takes, below that it takes an empty tree. So we are starting at the bottom of the tree, so at the leaves. Below that there's some kind of empty tree, and this production rule will consume this somewhat empty tree and also consumes the root node, which is an A. And then it goes to the state, which is, well, I can use any number, so I will start with Q0. You can imagine the bottom-up tree automaton that there will be a tree automaton starting in each one of the leaves. And they will go up in the tree and join or merge with each other. At the end, we want to have a single tree automaton at the root node, or the root node will be consumed, but we will be left with a single automaton, which should be in the final state so that the tree will be accepted. So this one will just start at the leaf. It will consume the A and go into the state Q0. And the other possibility is that we have those B, and we want to have a rule that can consume the B as a leaf node, so with an empty tree below it. And, well, let's say then this automaton should go into Q1. So now if you consider maybe this tree, then with the first rule, we will consume those A, and we will go into Q0. And with the second rule, we will consume the B and go into Q1. So then we have the next situation where we have an A node, and below those A nodes, so let me just write it as a new production. When we want to read this A, we want to write it like this again, we consume an A. But below that, we have two daughter nodes, and one is an automaton in state Q1. And one will be in the state Q0. And that's what we want to read when we are in this situation. And then let's just say this one will go to Q2. And if you look at this tree and we would do the same, then we would be left with an empty tree and the automaton in Q2. And that's why we want to have where we want to define Q2 as the final state. So at the end, when we reach the whole tree and the single left automaton is in Q2, then we will be fine and the tree will be accepted. So, but when we are in this case, let me do this in color. If we are not done yet and we consumed all the stuff and are left with the automaton in Q2, then we will also, well, if we apply this rule, we will also have this one consumed and be in Q0. And it doesn't matter where in the tree we are, because when we consume those A, because this is our only rule we have, then each one of those leaves will have an automaton in Q0. So when we are in Q2 on the right daughter node, I just write another new rule for this. We want to read the A, so we want to consume this A. And on the left daughter node will be Q0, and the right daughter node will be Q2. And so we want the automaton to go into Q2 as well. And now, as you may can imagine, but I can also start to make it clear to you, if our automaton would read this tree, then it would go into Q0, and here in every leaf it would go to Q0, 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 then when it consumes this leaf node, it will go to Q1, and then with this rule, then the A which would be here will lead to a transition to Q2, and if we are using the last rule, then it will just here we would have another Q0 on the left and a Q2 on the right side, so we would use the other rule and we would be left with another automaton in Q2 and here in Q2 and here in Q2 and here at the end, and also would go into the state Q2. So the whole tree would be accepted. So if I explained this clear enough to you, then these four rules are enough to read all the trees that are generated by this tree grammar.